Dear MP, so and so, so, I beg to apply for the position of. For this morning, I beg not to apply. You see, our educational system is a fraud. Our curriculum is 100 years behind. Our computer science students are being taught modern basic. When Japanese primary school children are being taught Python, Cobra, and what are you, Java. And here we are, getting PhD using a basic programming. How come? How? Challenge we are having today. Well, I hope I'm able to let you see the control. Thank you. Okay, this picture, if you can make a sense of it, this was 2014. So 143,000 graduates were applying for a job meant for about 1,000 plus. Out of that 1,000 plus, some people had actually gotten their children in January when these ones were gathered in Tedia all over Nigeria trying to get a job. Which some people had already, they are pocketed. So they were just coming here to do efficiency parade. They wanted to make you feel we are following due process. In that particular incident, 19 graduates died. Doing what? Begging to apply. It's a bad news that we have our society, the makeup of our educational system is conspired, is a conspiracy against the youth. Let me quickly give you an historical background to this. Before the independence, we had an educational system anchored by the colonialists. The colonialists actually structured our education to make us clerical staff, just good enough to move fast from here to there, and not good enough to be the thinkers and doers and innovators. That is why the highest aspiration of most of the people in the 60s and 50s was just, I want to be a civil servant. I want to be a top civil servant. I want to be a permanent secretary, to change files, to add zeros to figures, and to know how to, be corrupt like the British people who were handing over. After the independence, we thought it was going to be better. But by then, 1970s to 80s, we had the oil economy. And another deception kicked in. We were being trained to go and become oil explorationists and all those kinds of courses that had no real value addition to us as a people. We lost agriculture, we lost the things that were going to give us sustainable life, and we started pursuing those things that were going to bring destruction. Go to Niger Delta today. The oil has become a curse. Every water you drink from Niger Delta is mostly polluted. That is the kind of nation that we are defeated. But that is not the issue. I want to come back to you applying. The U.S. Department of Labor Statistics, in a recent research, said 43% of U.S. graduates are going to come out to see that they cannot get a job. Why? Because the education does not match the skill. If it is like that in U.S., there is a favorite passage I like to always remind myself. If this is happening to the wet tree, what will happen to the dry tree? If it is like that in the US, when 43% of graduates would come out without being fit for the labor market, what about Nigeria, where you are being taught the curriculum you are being taught? I hope there are no lecturers here, but if there are, I am sorry, sir. This is the reality of our time. And now, it is also in a recent research by the World Economic Forum, it was discovered that 67% big data. Please, how many of us are water? You and I are part of the over 1 billion users of water and 450 million monthly active users. What does that tell you? Now, you may not know, but Facebook last year bought water for 19 billion. That is more than the price of an oil rig. That is more than the price of an oil well. Why would you spend 19 billion buying a platform that you don't make a platform? Why would you spend 19 billion buying a platform that you just, there is, what is the value in it? But let me tell you something. Big data is the real oil well of today. So change your thinking. Reset your mind. If you have to change your mind, remove your brain and refit it this morning. Just understand that the things you are pursuing that are telling us is the real, is no longer real. The real thing is big data. Your email, your phone number, your I agree to a term and condition on the internet is generating millions and millions of dollars for somebody somewhere. That is why Mark Zuckerberg buy WhatsApp for 19 billion. Not Naira, Naira, dollars. Another thing, blockchain. You know, I'm a lawyer, but I'm not happy to say that, but I need to say it anyway. This profession is one of the dinosaurs of our generation. Is going into extinction. I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. If you are reading law and thinking about law the way they teach us in our classes, you are going to be out of job in the next 10 years or less. Of course, no lawyers, we know how to do our way, but I can tell you, if you want to strive in the coming economy, lawyers and so many middlemen are going to lose their job. Why? Recently, IBM Watson launched an app that can give you 87% correct analysis if you give it a legal problem to solve. If an app can tell you, I need this particular thing, and an app will give you 87% accurate information, well, even a senior advocate, the average correctness is less than 70%. Why would you not go for an app rather than going to a senior advocate? And do you know what? Senior advocates will collect millions. The app will collect less than $1. That is the power of disruptive technology. So if you are looking to change, I'm a lawyer, I work from why, I go from here to there, you are deceiving yourself, man. You need to rethink and reset your thinking. Blockchain.
Robots alone are taking up to 4% of jobs in Japan, and they are still
carry something. All of them are going to be taken by robots. So now, it is not the next 10 years is not going to be about those who have this huge chest. It's not going to be about six packs. It's going to be about brain packs.
Apply yourself to something that will make you different.